device as a teleportation device was accidentally discovered when they constructed a model of one of the drawings that was in Nikola Tesla's papers upon his death in 1943. And it just said Tesla energetic array, or energetic array in his original documents. And they didn't know at first that it was a teleportation device, a teleporter. They set it up there in that room in Curtis Wright. And what I was told is that a technician walked through the energy field to retrieve a screwdriver on a workbench in the lab, and he suddenly disappeared, so that his supervisor thought he had been disintegrated by this Tesla device. 6 weeks or 6 months later, he shows up at the door of the facility, of that very lab, and his supervisor collapses, literally collapses, believing that he's come back from the dead, or grateful that he didn't die in the development of this Tesla device, the construction of this Tesla device. And then he told the tale of how he fell through a tunnel, apparently in the time-space continuum, and popped out in Africa, where he was virtually deified by the local tribe that he had teleported to, until he explained that, no, I'm just an ordinary human being. He tried to communicate to them that in a way in which they would take him to the national government, he would be able to get home, and he did. And it was either 6 weeks or 6 months. I think it was 6 weeks. But that's, in fact, the story we were told in our training. So they realized that this Tesla device in Tesla's original papers that had actually been seized by the War Department, kept in the National Archives under the Alien Property Act in 1944, and then forwarded to Los Alamos when the Manhattan Project physicists began gathering there to build the atomic bomb, they thought, well, let's send Tesla's paperwork to the physicists in the world who can make the most sense of them. So ultimately they were sent to Los Alamos when the Los Alamos Scientific Laboratory was being started to build the atomic bomb, and that's where they remain to this day. Project Pegasus, quote unquote, owed its greatest debt of gratitude to Nikola Tesla. We did use some reverse engineering from downed extraterrestrial craft. We were given some technology by the ET groups that we were in liaison with during these years. But there's no question that time travel is the accomplishment of our species in this planetary context. It wasn't all reverse engineering. In the front of the room were two gray parentheses-shaped objects that looked sort of just like if you put your fingers on like this, sort of like closing parentheses. They were built into their bases, kind of like high-end stereo speakers, and they were about 8 feet high and about 10 feet apart on the floor of the lab there. And on the left boom, there was a technician sitting at a video console with a keyboard. And on the right side, the boom was plugged into a power outlet on the wall that was about the size of the power you would need to power a small-sized industrial piece of equipment, like an industrial lathe or drill press. And my dad had the technician turn on the device. And what I saw was essentially energy that was radiating between the two booms of the device, like water falling in a public sculpture. And then my dad had me go up towards the device, and it looked like raster on a TV set. And there were little squiggles at 3-inch intervals coming out of portals of light, sort of light lime green portals of light. So there were these bluish green squiggles that were swimming across the field of raster, kind of like tiny little tabs.